How's everybody doing?
Good, how are you?
Good.
Thank you.
Oh, don't fall.
No, I'm gonna get you a lot.
These are such cool tripods. Look at them.
Amazon.
They're all different. Yeah. They can like wrap around stuff.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks, Allison. Can't even keep ourselves hydrated.
I'm going to start with a fun question. If your character was a spokesperson for a product, what would it be?
Oh, that's easy for you.
I mean, it is, but it isn't, because you think it'd be something old-timey.
Yeah.
But I had a lot of fun this year playing with the Doc was on his phone a lot. So I think it'd be actually something futuristic, or I'd like to see, this wasn't your question, but I'm gonna steer it this way anyway, to lean into, like, if there was future stuff coming up, Doc really loved the future stuff.
Okay.
Like, I'd like to see him, like, sponsor spas. Doc just getting pampered, because he didn't have anything. I've been in a well for 150 years.
Right.
Came from the old West, where it's like, you know what I mean? He didn't know if he was getting, now he's just getting manicures, pedicures, his mustache done up, a robe, just complete, 100%. So I would say Doc would sponsor like some sort of spa or, yeah.
I can't be that. Like, how am I going to be that? I think it would just be like tequila or something.
Yeah,
you know?
There you go.
Like Don Julio.
Yeah.
Done.
Yeah. Perfect.
Yeah.
So being that we're here at Comic-Con, it's like Nerd Central, so what is something that you guys nerd out about? Is there anything you can't get out of?
Legos for me.
For me, I'm just a con. I'm a con. I was part of this family from day one. I used to come and do it on the other side, which is why it's so special. I used to go to conventions with my backpack and buy books and go through bins. And like, I'm a comic collector since I'm 10 years old. So for me, this is the best thing ever. I geek out on all of it. I made a tweet yesterday also about. Did you guys watch last night's episode? Well, in last night's episode, we get binded together, Jeremy, Doc, and Dolls, and I made a joke saying it was like an old school Red Book D&D binding spell that went wrong. And I said, anybody who gets my tweet gets me. Because it's super. And I said something about we need two 20-sided dies. So I'm like, it was like a super Dungeons and Dragons. You need to know. To know. So,
What's your favorite superhero then?
Silver Surfer. By far, yeah.
What was your favorite comic book?
Fantastic Four 48, because it was the first appearance of the Silver Surfer and Galactus, and that storyline was just everything to me. And I just love the idea of this this guy who's kind of lost, and he's doing something he doesn't want to do, and he doesn't know, he knows it's wrong, but he doesn't know why he's doing it. And at the end of the day, he's doing it for the woman he loves, and he did everything, sacrificed for her. I don't know. And he's on a surfboard in space. He's like, he's pretty good as far as superheroes go.
So what has it been like for you guys to watch the fandom for when grow? I mean, I'm sure that was still surreal when people are approaching you guys out on the streets and seeing how the different fandoms fill up and everything. Now it's growing so much.
We have by far the most amazing special fandom of any show. I mean of any show, and I mean of the bigger shows. I don't care. I'll say that, and I'll stand by it. These fans are amazing. They're also the only reason we're still sitting here. Their social media presence was huge, and it was great to be a part of, and I look forward to Friday nights. I think as genuine as they are, we become that genuine to reciprocate that love, because it's so genuine. Honestly, 96% of the people that you meet are amazing, and if the two little bad apples are a little of that percentage, they're amazing. So, what do you think is coming in to meet these new?
No one is throwing food at me.
Yeah, no food.
Dude, I had this nightmare, like fans were throwing. I'm like, no, please stop. No, but it. I completely agree. It's like, you know, you get scared because you're like, how am I going to be accepted, or this character, or, and everyone is just so incredibly welcoming and like, welcome to the, you know, the Earp family. I'm like, thanks guys, this is great. But yeah, it's I was an Earper first. Like, I watched all of the first season and all of the extra stuff on iTunes, and loved, you know, the comics and then the show. And me and my dad love westerns, and that's what brought us together. And I grew up on westerns, and having that be a part of, like, it's great. Yeah, the fandom is insane. It's something I've never experienced in my life, and we're so grateful and lucky to have such an amazing group of fans. Like, yesterday we did a live tweet with a bunch of them, and we had a lunch with a bunch of them too, and it was just like, and you can put faces, like, I don't know how, it doesn't make sense, because Twitter names, like, faces, yeah. like, oh my god, you're Doc Sash, that's fucking crazy.
Doc Sash,
you know, it's insane, it blows our mind that it's like, yeah.
Yeah, I talked to Melanie at the party. She was like, I know that. And I was like, TV After Dark. And then I showed her the logo. She's like,
yeah.
It's so great to, like, be able to do that. But yeah, because we all are behind these computers.
Yeah.
And we're connecting on something. And it's so nice that Comic-Con can, like, everyone just, like, and you connect in real life.
Yeah. 1 minute. So what kind of dad do you think Doc is going
to
be?
Well, after last episode, I really loved that he was just ready to be whatever she needed him to be. You know, and I think Doc is, he's accepting of the fact that if she decides that the two Earp sisters are going to raise this baby, and he's just there to be in whatever capacity she needs to be. I think that's what he's there to be, is a supporting, he's just a support role to Wynonna. You know, Wynonna doesn't need anybody for anything, so, and Doc, I think he loves that about her and accepts that about her, so I think he's ready to accept whatever role is there. I mean, I don't know now if the baby is his. So
that was yesterday's episode.
Right now he's kind of dealing with that.
And, yeah, that was heartbreaking. It's really hard to watch. I bawled.
I don't know. Do you want me to spoil it? Or I feel like it aired. So, she. Wynonna had a one night stand at the same time we were together with a remnant. So it's possible that the baby might be part Revenant.
That's bad.
It's time.
Okay.
Hey guys, thank you so much. It was so good meeting you.